Please, but if I'll give you subsidy over that, you will get that product for 50 rupees. Clear? So that is basically the subsidy. Clear? If someone will ask you what is subsidy, I hope after that, like now you can reply it, what is subsidies, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now coming to the next part over here. Now, whenever government do something, you know, some people are against it, some people are, you know, in favor of it, some people criticize it, right? So similarly, the problem was there, right? Some people were against, some people were together, right? So now let's just start. So argument against subsidies, like the people who were there, those who were against the subsidies, they said, once the technology is found profitable and is widely adopted, subsidies should be eliminated. Right. So what they said that once the like just a minute. Huh? Okay, so sorry. So see, subsidies are basically, for example, I am implementing a new technology, right? This chapter is all about agriculture. Like right now, the subsidies they were talking about in agriculture field only. So that's why we are not talking about other subsidies. We will only talk about the agriculture subsidies, right? So over here, what they thought that once the technology is found profitable and is widely adopted, subsidies should be eliminated since their purpose has been resolved. So subsidies are like, I'm introducing a new technology. Not everyone can afford it, right? Because they don't know whether it will be profitable for them or not, right? So similarly, what they said that, okay, subsidies keep them in a good way, like do everything, whatever you want to do. But keep that in mind that once, like everyone thought that, okay, like this technology is enough for us, like it is very good, then remove the subsidies. This was the plan. Like the people who were against it, they said that you don't need to keep it for lifelong. You just need to do a trial for it, like give the technology in a subsidized rate for few months. And after that, the people who think that it is profitable for them, then remove the subsidies, because if they think it's profitable, they can invest their money like that, right? And second, subsidies are meant to benefit the farmer, but a substantial amount of farmer subsidy also benefit the fertilizer industry. Now the problem is, for example, the farmers are getting the fertilizers at subsidized rate, right? So now government is, like earlier they were selling it for 100 rupees, but because of government, they are selling it for 50 rupees. So they were saying that this subsidy is for farmers only, but it is indirectly also profiting the fertilizers company, because their fertilizers are being sold at the subsidized, like government is providing them the sufficient amount, but automatically their sales is being increased, right? So fertilizers people, like the fertilizers industries and all that, they are already rich. Now because of the subsidies, it is, of course, it is benefiting the farmer, but indirectly also it is also benefiting the fertilizer industry. That's why you should remove this subsidies, right? Then third, among the farmers, the subsidy largely benefit to the farmer of most process. So there is no case of contributing to fertilizer subsidies. It does not benefit the target group. So they were saying, see, fertilizers are not the only thing. Apart from that, you need land, you need irrigation facilities, so many things. So they said that subsidy is only helping the farmer who can at least afford the irrigation facilities and all that. But the poorest farmer who cannot even afford one kg of manure or something like that, the subsidy is not benefiting them, right? Because with the help of HYV seeds and fertilizer, you cannot grow crop. There are so many other things that you need to take care of. And they say it is a huge burden of government finance. So of course, government is giving us that 100 rupees fertilizer, the 50 rupees subsidy raised, 50 rupees government is paying from their own pocket, right? So that's why they said that it is a burden on government finance. That's why you should remove the subsidies. Clear? Ritika, is it clear? Ritika, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, there were some people who were in favor of the subsidies. What they said, see, any technology which is considered risky by the farmer, subsidies should be given to them, right? So over here, it doesn't mean that once that, because not everyone will be rich to afford this, right? So therefore, they said that technologies are important because green revolution shall, like green revolution should also, you know, favor or also should profit the rich as well as small farmer. That's why you should not eliminate the subsidies even after the people are finding it profitable. Then government should continue with agriculture subsidies because farming in India continues to be risky business as it really depends on the monsoon. So people say that no matter about other part, but for this, subsidies should not be eliminated because government, because in India, most of the people are engaged in agriculture. Plus, agriculture is a risky. Once there is a monsoon failure or the pest attack, everything will be there. There will be crop failure, right? So therefore, in this field, government should not eliminate the subsidies. Most farmers are very poor and they cannot afford the required input without subsidies. So that's why you should not remove the subsidies. If you will eliminate the subsidies, it will basically increase the inequality between rich and poor. And because of this, the goal of equity will never be fulfilled and it will violate the goal of equity. If subsidies are largely benefiting the fertilizers industry and big farmer, the correct policy is to abolish subsidies, but to take steps to ensure that only poor farmers enjoy the benefit. So this is what, like if subsidies are benefiting the fertilizer industry and the big farmer, the correct policy is not to abolish subsidies, but you should make ensure that this benefit is being enriched by the small farmer, not by the rich farmer. So eliminating it is not the solution. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So you will first write subsidies, then you will write this subsidy, the full form, like definition of subsidies, and then argument against and arguments in favor.
ma'am.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Now, the first point, what technology are they talking about?
What's the technology? Like, for example, for irrigation, the technologies are there, right? For sowing the seeds, there's a technology. So, all this. Okay. Right? Related to agriculture only. Right? Instead of manual method, there are some, technological method as well, right? Earlier, everything was manual, using the blocks and all that, right? But now there are tractors, there are sewing machines, there are irrigation facilities, the pipelines and all that.
Okay. Ma'am, can you scroll down? Ma'am, you can scroll down. Done, ma'am.
Okay. Now moving to the next part, which is industry and the trade. Okay, agriculture we have already discussed. Now industry and trade. So 5-year plan placed a lot of emphasis on the industrial development, right? So in this 5-year plan, apart from agriculture, more focus was on industries. At the time of independence, the variety of industries was very narrow, largely confined to cotton, textile, and jute. You know that. So over here, one there was iron and steel, one in Jamshedpur, one in Kolkata. But obviously, we need to expand the industrial base, right? So what we did first of all, so the question is, ma'am, why first five, this five-year plan put it more important, like focus more on industrial development. Why? The reasons. First of all, economists have found that poor nation can progress only if they had a good industrial sector. So India was a poor country. So if India want to grow, so they need to focus on their industrial sector. Plus, because of industry, employment generation will be there. And because of this, because in agriculture, there is no stable thing, right? But in industry, they will get employment, plus there will be economic growth of the country. It promotes modernization and overall prosperity. So because of all this reason, they focus more on industrial development apart from agriculture, right? Now what happened? Public sector was given a leading role in the industrial development, right? Now the question is why, ma'am? See, public means government sector. So over here, at the time of independence, India industrial did not have the capital to undertake investment industrial venture required for the development of the economy. So over here, private sectors were not well developed at that time, and they were not that much rich. They don't have that much capital that they will invest a lot of money, because if you want to start an industry, you need a lot of money, right? So because of this, public sector was given a leading role. Second, the market was not big enough to encourage the industrial to undertake major product, even if the capital. For example, there were some people who had money, but there was nobody. You were not sure. You are starting something very fresh. So you are not sure whether, you know, you will get a profit from this or not that. So because of this, it was very difficult to encourage the industrial to take the undertake to major product and all that. Then, in addition, the decision to develop India's economy on socialist line led to the policy of state controlling the commanding height of economy. So over here, somewhere we were influenced by socialists. So we wanted to do the welfare for the country, and only government can do this. This meant that the government would be complete control of this industry. That's why that is going to be very important for the economy. So because of these three reasons, public sector was given the major role as compared to the private sector. Clear? So first you would put the heading industrial development, or you can write industry and trade, and then you can write this, the five-year plan because of this reason. Or you can put a question like this, why five-year plan emphasizes more on the industrial development? And then you will write answer because of the following reason and this.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, can you scroll down?
You can write the question. Why public sector was given a leading role in the industrial development in India? Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Hello, ma'am. Shake, just wait for 5 minutes. You joined early. I'm taking class. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.